Hello, John again. In the investment world, the less you know, the more you're guessing. And I'm not for guessing. We've taken some steps here on the 20th, which is Thursday, to really help us take advantage of what the market's currently doing. And you may say, John, what is the market currently doing? Well, you know what? In about four more minutes, you're going to really have a good handle on this. I've talked time and time again about being proactive, not reactive. So today what we did, Thursday, we sold some positions, we realized some gains, put those in the profits into cash. Why did I do that? I'm gonna share with you why. We have good reason to believe that in September and October, we're probably gonna see the market recede some, go down some. So we wanna get these profits while we have them, put them in our side pocket. And then what do we do with these profits once we have them in our side pocket? Well, when do you wanna buy stock? Do you wanna buy it when it's high or when it's low? Exactly. So we're anticipating that we're gonna have a lower market, may not, but in all likelihood we will. Now, as I say that, you should be thinking something else. What should you be thinking right now? When I say Bill or Mary, we think the market's gonna be lower here in the next couple months. Let me give you a hint, it has to do with your taxes. Every one of y'all should be doing Roth conversions. Now, maybe I shouldn't say everyone, but 99% of our clients should be doing a Roth conversion. And right now, the market goes down, we pay less for our conversion. So I'm gonna show you a little bit about that. So let's take a few moments, look at some charts. I want to give you an insight as to where we get this knowledge from and how we're seeing. Before we take a look at our technical charts, I want to draw some attention to something that's very important. It's interesting to me, I think the average person around the country, if you ask them, hey, what's the market been like this summer? They'd probably say okay, or maybe not so good, or maybe a little good. But if you look at it, the market's been quite remarkable this summer. And it's really been somewhat of an anomaly. You've heard the saying that says you go away in May. Well, had you done that, you would have lost a lot of money. This graph here, a chart, shows how our accounts did, our value strategy did this summer over 2.5 months. This right here, the 4.7, that's what the market did over 2.5 months, which, by the way, that equates out to an annual rate of return of over 22%. Our persistent value strategy, which is conservative value stocks, 20 of them, made 27.36, so about 20% more we got for no more risk. We made very, very good on our bonds over a two-month period. We made about a 30% annualized rate of return on our bonds. And look what we did with precious metals. So the summer did very, very well for us. We did better on the value strategy. But now let's take a step back and look at our more concentrated growth strategy. Growth stocks are different than value stocks. They're typically stocks that have got potential, much greater potential rate of return. They may not be as much of a value, but they can be big earners. Well, take a look. This summer, in 2.5 months, your growth strategy that you have has 13.3% growth. That's in a 2.5 month period of time. Extrapolate that over 12 months, that's about a 60% or 58% annualized rate of return. And the market, again, was at an annualized rate of return of roughly 22. Now, something else you do need to do, I'm sending you a link to watch Warren Buffett talked about concentrated portfolios, that large number of stocks reduce your overall rate of return. And one thing with our growth strategy is we don't have as many positions. These are just 12, but we've done extremely well. As my client or as an investor, what can you take of this knowledge? If growth strategy is going to make more than value strategy, what decisions might you make? I've already made it for you. You know, in your Roth, notice most all your Roth strategies, I've put in growth. Why is that? They won't make any more, but they're tax-free and they'll keep more. Now, let's turn some attention to charts and see why we're looking for the next few months to be kind of receding in the market and how we're going to take advantage of that. This is a very important graph. It shows something that gives us indication what the market's likely to do. As you look at it, the higher the line goes up, that indicates a greater volatility, higher volatility index, and the market responds by going down. So when this line is up, the market is more in a downward trend. And you'll see here that mid-July through early November, it's in a downward trend up until really September. And then we start seeing it go up, which means the market is likely to go down. Again, you can't set your watch by this every year, but it's been pretty accurate over time. This is another very, very important screen. It shows the over the presidential election cycle, what has occurred in the marketplace over different months. And you see here that in September and October, you have these two negative months. That's the 2 months right prior to the election. And then in November and December, that tends to go up again. So typical during these election year cycles,
that September and October are just down months. There's so much going on. It's the market didn't like it, and the market didn't like uncertainty along with the volatility. And so we are likely to see a downward trend. Again, part of the reason that we secured some of the profits we had here on Thursday. And we're seeing this as a potential setup for us to do very well going into next year. We talked a little bit about this recently. These are extensions. Extensions are very important data we look at. This is something that very few firms in the country have access to this data. We get this from Parallax. Y'all seen Chris Coppin speak in the office a couple times about this. And these extensions are recognized by these little pink marks up here. And we had one in the first part of August, which says the NASDAQ should be changing its direction. It had been going up at a good clip, and we do expect it likely to go down. And that's one reason we want to pare down some of our risk, some of our exposure, and raise some cash. We saw this extension here on a stock that I love a lot. I'm sure probably one of the most talked about stocks in the country is Apple stock. You can't argue it's a good stock. Even people as slow to move as Warren Buffett love Apple, but it's very expensive. You see here that we saw back in 2020, the start of 2020, you had an extension up here when the stock was way up. See how high it was? And what happened after the extension? It came right on down. So would you rather buy this stock up here or buy it down here? That's a rhetorical question. And here it's way up. We have 99. You cannot get any higher on these extensions than 99. So we think Apple's probably going to come the other direction. Apple's a big stock in the NASDAQ. It can affect the market as well. And the perspective we want to have on this is, here's the knowledge. What do we do with it? What we don't do is sit on hands and buy and hold. This is an opportunity, again, for Roth conversions and for buying stock at lower prices, which is what we all want to do. The last time we saw an extension in the NASDAQ was late last year. This is showing all in last fall. We had all the extensions. And then look what happened to it. It dropped way back down, and we got another extension on the bottom called a bottom extension. And after the bottom extension, it just went right on back up.
So just share some data that tells us it looks like the market's probably doing a big one down. That's not good or bad by itself. Not at all. It's how we respond to it. We've already taken those steps. One concern a lot of people have today, maybe you're one of those. I've heard this every week this year. John, what if there's a new president? What if the Democrats get in? What do you think is going to happen with the market if the Democrats get in? What's your feeling about that? I think you already have a preconceived notion. So we're all entitled to our opinions, but I think we're going to do better to deal with fact. Take a look at this last chart I have, and then answer the question, what happens if the Democrats get in? Let's take a peek.
I think you're likely to find some data here that's going to give you a different frame of mind going into the election. I think overall there's a probably an undue credit given to the president as far as his ability to affect the markets. I saw three or four years ago, I don't have it at my fingertips now, a chart that showed that in actuality the market had a better performance during Democratic administrations than Republican administrations. And I say that with a great deal of being unbiased because I'm not a Democrat or Republican, I'm an independent. But taking a look at it, during 2009 and Obama made 25.9. Back in 10, made 14.88. 83.3% of the time, the market's positive during Democratic administrations. Well, you know, how could we do well during a Democratic administration? They're spending so much money. That's what the Democrats are known for. I think that's a common conjecture. Well, think about that. That helps the market, doesn't it? Look at the $7 trillion put into the market. The government this year has had a profound effect on the market. So I think high spending puts more money in the economy, helps us overall. And I think at the end of the day, we're going to do smart well by making good decisions.
I really hope this has landed on your ears. I've shared a lot of information in a short period of time. I'm going to wrap it all up in a tight ball. Why did we have such a good summer? We shouldn't have. The economy was in shambles. The market did well. First lesson, the market leads the economy. People focus on the economy. That's not what indicates how the market's going to do. This government, this country, put $7 trillion into the economy. Goldman Sachs is calling for a 20% increase in the market between now and the end of the year due to the liquidity in the market, all the cash, and the fact that there's a strong belief of an antidote for the virus or vaccine by the end of the year. This cash has been mentioned a lot recently in different articles I've read. It's not just the United States. Globally, all this cash in the market is looking for a place to go. It goes to market, it'll shoot up. right now, that the virus is a vaccine. And I think, can you bar the door? I think we have a tremendous next year. And you look at the trillions and trillions of dollars that have gone into government securities. Watch what happens to those, y'all. The same thing that happened in 08. People go there for safety. When they feel comfortable, it comes out of treasuries back into the market. Lastly, please watch this video from Warren Buffett, the guy I respect a lot. I've taken some of what I learned from him and put into these strategies. Our growth strategy is doing very, very, very well as value. But growth's doing a whole lot more. One reason is its growth. What's the other reason? What's the other reason our growth strategy has done so well? Think about it. It's only 12 stocks. Be sure to watch Warren Buffett's video. Shoot back your questions to me. Take care.